Justin Fields at quarterback. So that's a gimme. No battle there. Nothing to talk about. We don't even need to go through the superlatives because they're obvious. Is there any way, other than getting the knee healthy so he can be the true dual threat quarterback that he's been known to be with 10 rushing touchdowns and 41 passing last year, any type of marked improvement that we could expect this year?
I think so. And I think, you know, maybe it won't be as obvious to the average fan, but I think he spent a lot of time this offseason continuing to look back at what went well and what didn't last year. And there wasn't a ton that didn't go well. He only threw three interceptions, and two of those came in the final game against Clemson. So, you know, it's hard to do that. But when you're Justin Fields, when you're Ohio State, you're going to nitpick a little bit and try and figure out, you know, where he can get better. I think decision-making is one thing, and we saw that improve throughout the season. But there were times when he put the ball up and you know, maybe an ill-advised pass that wasn't intercepted or just didn't hit the mark. Obviously, a second year in the offense. You mentioned his ability to run, which we saw some last year, especially in the bigger games. But that knee injury certainly hampered him in the final three games after Penn State. So that's part of the offense that we may see a little bit more, especially with no J.K. Dobbins in the backfield. You know, they're probably going to use a little bit more quarterback run at times, or at least the threat of that. So I think he's worked hard this off season, even though they haven't been at the facility very much. He spent time back at home in Georgia working with various quarterback coaches and with other players around the area to continue to stay sharp. So I expect him to just kind of take that next step, you know, as good as he was last year. That was his first year as a starting quarterback, so he didn't have a ton of film to go back and look at and whatnot. There wasn't a lot of evaluation you could do from year one to year two because he didn't play when he was at Georgia all that much. So now that he's got that, I think that's kind of where you go is really breaking down, hey, I could have done this a little bit better. I could have placed this ball a little bit more accurately. Things like that maybe don't, you know, come up when you're just watching a game casually, but I'm sure the Ohio State coaches have identified areas where he can improve.
And much like the argument for best team in the country coming down to Ohio State, Clemson, and Alabama for those three, the argument for best quarterback in the country pretty much revolving around Trevor Lawrence and Justin Fields and only those two. I could make the argument, I think just about anybody could make the argument that this team could win a Big Ten championship. I don't know about competing in the playoff, but could still win the Big Ten without Justin Fields. And so what's the backup quarterback situation look like?
Yeah, that's probably their biggest, when we're talking about quarterback, their biggest improvement from a year ago is that they have some depth at quarterback. You know, last year, Chris Chuganoff, Gunnar Hoke were the two backups, but neither of them had a ton of experience. Neither of them were of the same type of Ohio State quarterback level as Justin Fields. Chris Chuganoff's gone. Gunnar Hoke is probably the number two heading into fall camp since spring practice was cut short. But the major difference is going to be they've got two highly recruited freshman quarterbacks that are coming in. Now, those guys don't boast experience, C.J. Stroud from California and Jack Miller from Arizona, but they've got a lot of talent, and Ohio State's very excited about the future of the position with those two. I think it's going to be an interesting battle to watch what happens come fall camp between those two, because whoever wins the number two or number three job, however you want to lay it out, is probably getting a leg up on who becomes the starting quarterback if and when Justin Fields decides to leave after the 2020 season for the NFL draft. But those are guys that I imagine Ohio State will want to get in games, you know, when they have a big lead, especially early in the year, to try and get them some experience and see them in game action. You know, there's been discussion about whether or not one of them would redshirt because you have two quarterbacks in the same class. You know, if Ohio State feels like they need to play both of them to get an idea of what they can do, it wouldn't surprise me if they play both of them. They've got another quarterback coming in the following year, so redshirting may not even be an area of concern for this position. But I think you're certainly, if you're Ryan Day and the offensive staff, feeling more comfortable with the depth if something were to happen to Justin Fields, just because you have more talent there than you did the year before. Still not a ton of experience in terms of college snaps, but definitely more talent. These guys are you know, players that will probably become household names at some point during their career. And, you know, it'll be up to Ohio State to decide how much we see of them in the fall.